Sean Terry here. Flip2Freedom.com, Flip2Freedom.com. And I just got an email from a lady by the name of Denise. And she said that she does not have any confidence in herself to do this business. Now, I know you may be fearful or wondering if this is for you. And by the way, where am I? I'm at Catalina Island right now and hanging out for the day over here. It's been awesome. But I got this email and I'm like, listen, I just wanted to make this video real quick because, you know, I didn't have confidence in myself either. And I think anybody who has become massively successful doesn't come out of the gate with massive confidence. They just don't. So what happens is two things. Either one, they develop it over time by doing the same thing over and over again, you know, or they fake it till they make it. It's not fake it, go buy a Lamborghini if you can't afford it. Fake it till you make it means fake your confidence if you don't have it. Act as if. So what does that mean? So by doing something over and over and over again till you get confidence, what does that mean, right? So basically what it means is this, is that think about if you're gonna ride a bike. You know, you get on the bike, you're unconfident, it's shaky, it's weird, you don't have any balance whatsoever, right? And then what happens is if you do it over and over again, you establish a balance, you get momentum, you start to ride, you understand how to put your foot on the pedal. And I know this because, you know, I've taught both of my daughters, you know, how to ride bikes, and now they have no problem riding and they're 100% confident in doing it. Same with riding a car, with basically driving a car. When my daughter first got behind a car, she was freaking out. Now I got a 14-year-old that's about to learn how to start driving now. Now I'm freaking out, right? So the bottom line is that she got behind the wheel of a car. She was unconfident at first. She didn't know what she was doing. She didn't have perception of exactly what was going on around her, but she knew she wanted to do it. She knew she had to drive, and she knew she wanted to be a driver, right? So in a car. So, you know, so what happens is you have to do it repetitive. Same thing to be a real estate investor. You got to do it over and over again. You got to talk to the sellers. You got to book appointments. You got to meet with the sellers. You got to screw up. You got to do it over and over and over again until you're so confident that you get great at it. That is one way, you know, to become confident is know what you want. 110%, know that you want to become successful, know that you want to do that, and then take the steps forward knowing that you're going to be, you know, you're not going to have balance and knowing you're going to be afraid, but completely focusing on getting better each step of the way. You know, when you get on that bike, you're going to fall off. Well, you don't fall off forever. You get back on the bike and you do it over. You have a tenacity and you have this drive that I'm going to figure this out no matter what. I don't care what it takes. I'm going to do it over and over and over again, right? So that's the type of attitude you have. The second thing is fake it till you make it, right? Here's the thing is you know, most people don't know you. Most people you meet with, sellers and stuff like that, buyers, title companies, they don't know you. So you have the ability to be anybody you want to be. So what if you were confident? How would you act? What if you were dynamic? What if you were good with people? What if you weren't an introvert and you were an extrovert just for this point in time? You know, I always tell my daughter, you've got, you know, all you gotta be is confident for 5 seconds. If you can be confident just for 5 seconds, what's gonna happen? It's gonna get you through that taking action thing that we're talking about right here. So the bottom line is this, is that is act as if. What if you could be successful? What if you could be confident? How would you act if you were confident, right? You pick up the phone and you talk to the seller as if you're confident. You go meet to the house and you might not know what the heck's going on. You might be walking around, but you're gonna walk around with authority. Why? Because you're acting as if. They don't know the difference if you're brand new or not. The bottom line is they're gonna turn around and they're gonna follow your lead. Why? Because you're gonna act as if you're confident. Don't be afraid. And here's the thing is that, you know, you got two different options. Either A, believe your story that you're unconfident and continue getting what you've always got, or create a new story that you are confident and you can accomplish amazing things in this world. There's nothing you can't accomplish. So here's the thing, the choice is yours, right? What do you want to do? Do you want to just literally be in a position where you continue to get what you've always got? Telling the same story of being unconfident, you can't do it, you're not confident in your own abilities? or start being confident, act as if you're confident, and put forth the effort to get better and better every single day. So guess what? When the time comes, you will rise to the occasion. Why? Because you want to. And you will go out and do it, and you will talk to the seller, and you will make an offer, and you will get the contract, and you will go out there and find a buyer, and you will sell the property, and you will turn around and make $5,000 or $10,000, $15,000, and you will go out there and change your life. Why? Because you are meant to do it, and you can make this happen. So I just wanted to make this real short video because I was just thinking to you, you have the confidence. Don't believe that story. Change the story and either A, turn around and do it every single day and you can, until you have this sucker down, or B, act as if. That's my 2 cents for the day. So have an awesome one. Take care. God bless. And I'll see you soon.